Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss some important questions from the topic alternative investment funds. So this is an important topic if you are preparing for SEBI grade examination. So guys, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. Now let's see question number one. SEBI introduced AIF regulations in 2012. Some funds are specifically excluded from the purview of AIF regulations. Which of the following is not excluded? So, you should know that SEBI has introduced AIF regulations in the year 2012, and as per these regulations, some funds or some trust, they are specifically excluded. So like ESOP trust, they are excluded, mutual funds, collective investment scheme, employee welfare trusts, gratuity trusts. So these trusts or these funds, they are excluded from the definition of alternative investment funds. So now let us see the options. So mutual funds, so they are excluded. ESOP trust, they are also excluded. Collective investment scheme, they are also not a part. So mutual funds, collective investment scheme, they have separate regulations. So they do not come under the AIF regulations and they are not a part of alternative investment funds. Hedge fund, so yes, hedge fund, it is not excluded because hedge fund is a type of alternative investment fund. Right, so the correct option is D. And E part, gratuity trust, they are also excluded. So accordingly, the correct option is D, hedge fund. Now moving on to the next question, question 2. Alternative investment fund is a privately pooled investment vehicle incorporated in India, which collects funds from sophisticated high net worth investors. So you are given three statements. You have to see which of them is correct and which of them is incorrect. So before that, I would like to tell you that alternative investment funds, they are for large investors, large or rich investors, because the minimum subscription amount is large, and mutual funds, they are generally for small investors. Now three statements are given below. AIF are classified into three categories, category 1, 2 and 3. So statement 1 is right, because as per SEBI regulations regarding AIF, they are classified into three categories, category 1, 2 and 3. So in category 1, we have VC funds, venture capital funds, angel funds, then there are SME funds. So these funds come under category 1. In category 2, you have private equity funds, debt funds, real estate funds. And in category 3, we have hedge funds, and then there are pipe funds, and there are other examples also. So statement 1 is right. Statement 2, a manager and sponsor of an AIF can be the same person. Now first of all, you need to know who is a manager and who is a sponsor of a fund. So manager is the person who manages the investments of the fund. So it manages the investments. And sponsor is like a promoter. So sponsor is a person who sets up the alternative investment fund or who establishes the fund. So there can be a single sponsor also, and there can be more than one sponsor also, right? And manager and sponsor, they can be the same person and they can be different also, right? So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, an alternative investment fund can be established in the form of company or LLP only. Now this statement is wrong. Why? Because as per AIF regulations 2012, an AIF can be set up in one of the four forms. So what are those four forms? So company, so an AIF can be set up in the form of a company or LLP or trust or any body corporate, right? So one of the four forms. So statement 3 is wrong because they are saying that AIF can be established in only company form or LLP form. No, it is not right because it can be formed in company, LLP, trust or body corporate. So one of the four forms. So you can see only statement 3 is incorrect. So the question is asking you which of the following statement are incorrect. So the correct option is C, statement 3. Now moving on to the next question, question 3. So friends, before discussing the question, I would like to tell you that I have also discussed this topic on our Telegram group. So on that group, we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions. Also, a lot of relevant information is being shared. So do join our Telegram group. The link for the group is provided in the description section below. Now question 3. SEBI has classified alternative investment funds into three categories, Consider the below statements regarding categories of AIFs. So in the previous question, I told you that SEBI has classified AIFs into three categories. So now in this question, we are given three statements. So we have to see which of them is correct and which of them is incorrect. So statement one, category one and two funds cannot undertake leverage or borrow for long term, whereas category three funds can use leverage. Now this statement is right. So let me draw a table of distinction between the three. So category one and two, they can't take leverage, but category three, it can take leverage. So basically it means that category one and category two funds, they cannot borrow for long term. They can borrow for short term operations. So for day to day operations, they can borrow, but they cannot borrow for long term. Whereas category three funds, they can borrow for long term purpose also. So that is why category three funds are more risky and they need to be more regulated. So statement one is right. Now statement two, category one funds can launch only close ended scheme, whereas category two and three funds can launch both open ended as well as close ended schemes. So before discussing this question, you need to know what is open ended scheme and what is close ended scheme. So this classification of open ended and close ended, it is also there in mutual funds. So basically in open ended scheme, an investor can enter anytime in the scheme and he can also exit anytime. But a closed-ended scheme, it is open for a specific time period. So an investor has to invest within that time period only. And also open-ended scheme, there is no fixed redemption period. But in closed-ended scheme, there is a fixed redemption period. So these are the major differences between the two schemes. So according to AIF regulations, category 1 and category 2 funds, they can launch only close-ended schemes. But category 3 funds, they can launch close-ended as well as open-ended schemes. So statement 2 is incorrect. And statement 3, the minimum tenure of schemes launched by category 1 and 2 funds has to be 3 years. Now you need to know one thing, that in a close-ended schemes, there is a fixed tenure. But for open-ended schemes, there is no fixed tenure, right? So category 1 and category 2 funds, they can launch only close-ended schemes, as I have just told you. So their tenure has to be fixed. And as per the regulations, the minimum tenure should be 3 years. So minimum 3 years. Redemption period has to be minimum 3 years. But there is no such time limit for category 3 funds because they can also launch open-ended schemes and there is no redemption, fixed redemption period for category 3 funds. So statement 3 is right. So you can see that only statement 2 is incorrect, right? So the correct option here is B, statement 2. Now question 4. Now before discussing question 4, I would like to tell you that we have also posted this quiz on our website. So we have posted other quizzes also on different topics on our website for different exams. So you can visit the website and attempt those quizzes. So basically you will get to know your preparation level and also you will learn a lot from those quizzes. So the link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now question 4, a few statements related to provisions regarding investment in AIFs are given below. Which of the following statements are incorrect? So you are given 5 statements. So we have to see which of them is incorrect. So these statements are regarding provisions related to investment in AIFs. So there are some provisions as per AIF regulations 2012. There are some provisions regarding investment in AIFs. So let us see statement one by one. Statement one, every scheme of the AIF shall have a minimum corpus of 20 crore rupees. So this statement is right. So you need to know what is the meaning of corpus here. So corpus, you can say it is the investable pool. So the amount contributed by investors in a scheme. So it is called corpus. So the investable pool. So statement one is right. Statement two, no scheme of the alternative investment fund shall have more than 1,000 investors. So this statement is also right because as per AIF regulations, the maximum number of investors in a scheme can be 1,000. So maximum 1,000 investors can be there in a scheme of AIF. Now statement 3, each investor apart from employees or directors of AIF or manager has to invest a minimum sum of 1 crore in the AIF. So the minimum subscription amount is 1 crore for the investors, but for employees or directors of AIF or manager, the minimum subscription amount is 25 lakhs. So for employees or directors, the minimum subscription amount is 25 lakhs, and for the rest of investors, the minimum subscription amount is 1 crore. So you can see minimum subscription amount is very large. That is why I said that AIFs, they are for high net worth or rich investors, and mutual funds, they are for ordinary investors. So statement 3 is also correct. Now statement 4, AIF can collect fund through public issue or private placement. Now this statement is wrong. Why? Because as per AIF regulations, an AIF can collect fund only through private placement. So an AIF is not allowed to raise money through public issue. It can only go for private placement, and for that it issues a placement memorandum. So statement D is incorrect. And statement E, an alternative investment fund can raise funds from any investor, whether Indian, foreign or NRI, by way of issue of units. So this statement is right. So an AIF can raise money from any investor and it issues units. So like in mutual fund, investors get units. Similarly, in AIF also, investors get units. So basically, an AIF issues units against the corpus or against the investable pool of money. So accordingly, statement D is incorrect. So the correct option is D. Next question, question 5. So it says, consider the statements given below regarding alternative investment funds. So you are given three statements. So let us read the statements. Statement 1, sponsor or manager of a category 3 AIF needs to appoint a custodian irrespective of the size of corpus of AIF. So let me draw a table of distinction. So the regulation regarding appointment of custodian. So basically the regulation state that category 1 and category 2 funds, they need to appoint a custodian if the size of the corpus is more than 500 crore. So category 1 and category 2 funds, they need to appoint a custodian if their corpus size is more than 500 crore. But for category 3 funds, there is no such threshold limit. They need to appoint a custodian irrespective of the corpus size. So statement 1 is right. Now statement 2, angel funds are registered under category 3 of AIFs. So this statement is wrong, because I told you in the beginning only that angel funds, they come under category 1. So basically in category 1, we have VC funds, and angel funds are a part of VC funds only. So angel funds, they are considered a part of VC fund. So accordingly, angel funds also come under category 1. So statement 2 is incorrect. And statement 3, an AIF can launch a scheme only after filing placement memorandum with SEBI. Now this statement is right, because as per the regulations, before launching any scheme, the fund needs to file a placement memorandum. So placement memorandum is basically like a prospectus only. So the placement memorandum contains information regarding the scheme, the tenure of the scheme. It also contains information about the manager, sponsor and other related information. So as per the regulations, AIF needs to file placement memorandum with SEBI at least 30 days before launching the scheme. So at least 30 days before launching the scheme, it needs to be filed with SEBI. So statement 3 is right. So you can see only statement 2 is incorrect, right? So the question is asking you which of the following statement is incorrect. So only statement 2 is incorrect. So the correct option is C, statement 2. Now the final question. So it says, which of the following is not an alternative investment fund? So you are given 5 options. You have to tell which of these is not an alternative investment fund. So your options are hedge fund, private equity fund, mutual fund, angel fund and venture capital fund. So I'm not going to tell you the answer to this question now. You need to tell me the answer to this question in the comment section below. Then afterwards, I will post the right answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do hit the subscribe button to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.